Hey, who doesn't like a cold beer every now and then? Everyone has their favorites, from ales to stouts, from lager to porters. And we like ours with a crab cake. Today on This Crab Cake, we're joined by some of the beer gurus, or as we call them, brew-yous, from Katcef Brothers. And we're going to talk, you guessed it, beer.
Hey, we're back here and we're going to talk about beer again. And we're with the lovely Lauren Hamilton, who was with us last month. And
hi, thanks for having me.
And I see you left left Bill away, and he didn't bring beer, but...
I did. I left the beer guy away. No, we have no magic bag of beer today, unfortunately.
No magic bag? Well, joining us, we have Mike LeViseur. Do you have a magic bag?
I don't. I just sell beer. That's all I do.
And joining us from the Military Bowl is Josh Barr. Do you have a magic bag full of beer?
I like to drink beer.
Oh. Okay, well, we are at Heroes Pub on Riverview Avenue in West Annapolis, and we're just going to have to drink their beer. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about a new beer that's coming out from Budweiser.
Yep.
Called a Budweiser Copper Lager.
Copper Lager, yep, you got it.
I want to say Copperhead, but that's a Fordham beer, but that's okay.
We're mixing genres a little bit, but that's okay, yeah.
And an exciting repeating event, but we're going to talk about Who's Your Hero, which is a program, I guess is the word that I want to say, that Katcef Brothers developed about 4 years ago.
Yeah, so actually Cassie, who was with us last time, our marketing director, she came up with this program about 4 years ago to honor the heroes that we all have in our lives. And so we run it every year starting on Veterans Day.
So let's get right into that, first of all, about the Who's Your Hero. This is, which I think is so cool, because when you think of heroes, you think of the military guys and the camouflage and the backpacks and everything else. And it certainly is that. And that's what the Military Bowl is all about. And it's, you know, it's the legacies and everything else. But it's not just that. Their heroes come in, and there's a country song, which I'm not a country fan, about heroes or something like that. I can't remember who sings it, but there's all sorts of different heroes in everybody's life. So you're not limited to nominating a military person, correct?
No, you're not. Heroes come in many forms. You know, we all have our own, you know, people that have impacted our lives and that we look at as heroes. So whether it's first responders or whether it's a family member that's overcome adversity or a friend, or there's any number of ways that you can take that.
Teacher, a neighbor,
yeah,
whatever it is. Everybody's
eligible. We don't discriminate.
It's a hero. Hero in your life. And as far as the, gosh, I don't want to say contest because it's not really a contest, but the promotion goes, is that you nominate a hero, tell us why you think he's a hero.
Or she.
Or she. Right. Or she. Yep. Right. Or
oh,
she.
Man. Okay. The Me Too movement comes right in here.
I'm sitting right here, you guys. I'm included too.
But yeah, why he or she is a, you know, is a hero in your life. And you can do that online at militarybowl.org/budheroes. You can come to, you're going to have plenty of events that are going to be scattered throughout the town where you can actually come and personally nominate your hero, which is really kind of cool. You can come out and meet the Budweiser team that is going to be here because they're one of the sponsors of the Military Bowl.
Ooh, that's our boy Mike here sitting to my right.
That's right.
So like she said, we have multiple events going on throughout the month, obviously starting off this weekend at Heroes Pub. What better place to where you see just a different type of genre of people coming here? I mean, including firefighters, teachers, police workers, ex-military people. There's no better place, I think, to kick off this on Veterans Day than Heroes Pub.
That's true. And Heroes is in West Annapolis on one Riverview Avenue, November 11th, which is Sunday. Be 1 o'clock p.m. here till 3 o'clock p.m., right?
Yes, and we'll be sampling our Budweiser Copper Lager as well, and they'll be running a special on Budweiser Draft. It'll be $2.99 Budweiser Drafts and $3.99 Copper Lagers, so nice, easy, you know, good time to try it out, and we'll also have a sampling team out here to help sample the beer if you're interested just to try it before you buy it.
What's the Budweiser Copper Lager all about?
So Bud Copper Lager is actually, so it's a new variation of Budweiser. It's a limited release that we did in collaboration with Jim Beam. So it is a Copper Lager aged on Jim Beam staves. So we kicked it off during Bourbon Heritage Month back in, I believe that's September, and it'll run through the early part of 2019 as far as availability goes. And it is a sort of an homage to the decades-long pairing of Budweiser and a shot of whiskey. So we basically took everybody's favorite beer in a shot and created a beer out of it.
Sounds like a George Thorogood song to me. It's
you know, it's really just a nod to two all-American brands. You know, you've got Budweiser, you've got Jim Beam, and nothing like this has ever been done before. No beer and spirit has ever collaborated in this way in the past, so it's a really, really neat collaboration. You'll see it in liquor stores, and you'll see it in bars. You'll see some cross-merch with Jim Beam in some of those liquor stores, so you'll see some Budweiser Copper Lager next to some Jim Beam. So it's a really neat opportunity. opportunity, and the liquid is absolutely
Have you
fantastic.
Tasted it, Lauren?
I have. I love it.
Does it have any Jim Beam taste into it?
You know, it doesn't have a super bourbony taste. It has a really nice sort of bourbon note, but really it's just a really nice smooth malt flavor. So it actually drinks relatively lightly. It's a really nice clean finish. It's a fantastic beer. They absolutely hit the nail on the head.
Okay, well, there you go. Try out the Budweiser Copper Lager, and that's only going to be available for a couple months. So.
Yeah. Try it while it's here.
And when is it releasing? I mean, I know you said we're going to have it here on Sunday, but...
Yeah, so we actually, it's actually here at Heroes as of today. We'll be doing some events with it in collaboration with Hoosier Hero, just because it's such a natural tie-in with Budweiser and Jim Beam and our Heroes program.
Give it a try.
Certainly
come on out here on Sunday for the Military Bowl kickoff for the Hoosier Hero. And give it some thought to your heroes. And again, as you said, it can be a male or a female, and it's just a hero in your life. I know I've got teachers. My father is one of mine. I mean, he fought in World War II. And as he got older, before he died, he started to tell the stories that he never told throughout his life, which was fascinating. And I just really regret not having to be able to talk to him a little bit, or him not being comfortable enough to talk about his experiences down in the South Pacific prior to him passing.
Yeah.
You know, we just heard a couple little funny stories all our life, but he held everything back in. It was kind of cool. So everybody does have a hero in your life. It's not just about nominating them. I mean, there is some swag involved here.
There's some swag. You know, the other thing that's really cool about these events is that there is the opportunity to share your hero stories with others' hero stories. So the way that we do this is everybody gets one of those little cards that you can write down who's your hero. You can write, you know, why, and it goes up on the wall, or it goes, you know, kind of gets passed around. You'll see them out on the tables, and it creates kind of a conversation amongst everybody there that's at these events to really talk about what matters to them and their heroes.
And then it goes up on the website.
It does go up on the website.
Before they pick the winners of this, I believe there is a panel of judges that's brought in to review all of them and cry.
That'd be an emotional day. Reading all of these hero stories would be definitely an emotional day.
It's amazing. You know, we've run this promotion for 4 years now, I think, and it never ceases to amaze. Like, you read these stories and you're like, holy cow. And it doesn't have to be like John said, you know, it's not necessarily like somebody in the military. Could be somebody who's a relative, but whatever it is, you know, all these people from different walks of life who have impacted, you know, people in different ways and made this lasting impression, you know, that they remember from 20, 30 years ago, even. Like, that's the person who shaped the person they are now. It's pretty amazing.
Well, it really is. It's when you think about it, anybody you meet any day of the week is going to shape your life in some way, shape, or form. Some obviously more than others and whatnot. And it's really kind of cool. I mean, you hear all the time about teachers. You know, I know my third grade teacher. So, I mean, there are teachers that do it. There are obviously firefighters or the I don't want to say the obvious heroes, but the people that we would typically think of heroes to do that. Nominate them. If you're selected, there's five of them that are going to be chosen as far as the winning, I don't want to say stories, but the winning heroes. The hero and their nominee will get a ride in the Military Bowl Parade, which will be led by the Budweiser Clydesdales.
Yeah, we're bringing them back. We talked about them last time. Mm-hmm. We're bringing mm-hmm. them back.
And the cat is out of the bag. They're going to have a meet and greet with the Clydesdales the day before the Military Bowl on the 30th of December in West Annapolis.
Yes, going back onto that, we're very excited with them. It's going to be a little bit earlier this year. I mean, obviously last year we had a 6-degree day, so we're hoping for a little bit better weather this year. But we still had a great crowd that came out, and we're looking forward to again this year. We're working with the West Business Annapolis Association, so we're very excited to be partnered up with them. They have some cool ideas that they're throwing into the mix this year. Possible food trucks and other vendors might be available just to enhance the experience. And it's really an honor and a privilege to have the Clydesdales available for people to see. I remember the first time I saw a Clydesdale. My breath was taken away, and I work for the company, and I see pictures of them all every day, and I'll never forget Nats Park opening day was the first time I ever got to see a Clydesdale
wow.
up close.
I get the emails all the time, but just piggybacking on that, like, somebody emailed me this week asking for advice on when they should come and the best way to come see the Clydesdales in the parade. And I was like, well, if you get there at, say, 7-ish in the morning down by City Dock, that the trucks will pull in. It'll be pretty empty. But inevitably, there is a group, there's a couple dozen people there who come down just to see them unload.
It's an amazing experience.
That is, to watch them saddle, they don't
harness,
saddle,
you know, but harness.
Harnessing them up, or hitch them up and everything else. And I remember last year we got a chance to talk to, I would say one of the Clydesdales, but one of the keepers on our podcast. And it was just really fascinating about the different teams that they've got and how they travel and everything else. And unfortunately, the horses weren't willing to talk on microphone. So, but that's some dates there. Everything seems to be centralized around West Annapolis. Anyhow, so we get five people that are going to be chosen as selected from the hero nominees, and they and their nominator will get a ride in the Military Bowl Parade up to the game. There is what? You get on-field post-game.
Well, the ride is pretty special also. They're going to be riding. The ride, I believe, is going to be on Sea Brisket, which is okay. Mission Barbecue's boat that they keep down at the harbor.
That's right? An amazing name.
Okay.
Isn't it great?
Sea Brisket.
That was a contest. I remember that, to name that.
That just made my day.
So they will ride on Sea Brisket during the parade up to the stadium. And we'll have some hospitality up at the stadium. They'll be recognized during the game. And, you know, I think we spoke with the weather coordinator. We put in for 65 and mostly sunny, so we should be good to go.
Well, good. Well, we got that out of the way anyway. Anyhow.
You might want to follow up on that as we get a little closer to that date and make sure.
This is a lot of excitement coming up into this, and it all gets kicked off on Sunday here. Now, let's talk about the Military Bowl, Josh. Who's going to be in it?
Oh, I think we've got Alabama Clemson's booked.
I'm wearing a Navy
again,
shirt right now.
Again, you might want to follow up on that one.
Yeah, so once again this year we're going to have teams from the ACC and the American Athletic Conference. The announcement will be made on Sunday, December 2nd, and until then, really, it's a crapshoot. Week by week, we look at it. We look at the possibilities and who might be in line for the game, and it changes from week to week, and we see the, you know, the quote-unquote experts and all their prognostications, and we're like, really? We don't see how it's viable or possible. You know, certainly there's some teams on the American side that make sense for us, but we don't know how it's going to shake out. You have on one side, you've got UCF, USF, and Houston. Obviously, UCF is still undefeated. They could be in line for a New Year's Six game. Then you have Cincinnati and Temple in the other division, who are both having strong seasons. And then on the ACC side, I mean, good gosh, everybody could be bowl eligible, just about, other than North Carolina and Louisville. You know,
so the teams, do the teams get a choice in coming, or is that just a bowl pick?
No, team? On the ACC side, there's a pecking order to it all, and then the American side is a little bit more of mixing with the conference and talking about what teams fit best. You know, we feel pretty comfortable given who's out there. You know, we're looking forward to a game that's going to have another 30,000-plus people in the stands. This year, you know, we could have, you know, it's possible we could have a team like Virginia Tech or Pittsburgh come back, or Cincinnati, who have all played in the game since it's been in Annapolis, or we could have somebody new. Three of the past 5 years we've been in Annapolis have been sellouts. One year, Maryland Marshall was close to a sellout, and Temple Wake Forest 2 years ago drew a pretty big crowd as well.
Right.
So, you know, we've had good crowds every year, and we think that given who's out there, you know, we're part of the recipe is having teams where the fans can drive in. It's a 3 or 4 hour drive, 5 hour drive. They come in, they come to the game, they spend a night or two in a hotel, they experience all that Annapolis has to offer. You know, they do things like the wine walk and the bar crawl, and they really get out and enjoy things in town.
Well, you say wine walk and bar crawl, so I mean, there's much more going on aside than the football game, which is noon.
Yeah, football game kicks off at noon on New Year's Eve Monday, so you know, we're looking at it's kicking off the new year. You know, at noon, the teams come in the 27th is the plan, although they might come in earlier. And they stay in Washington for a few days, and they practice, and they see some of the sights in D.C. And then things in Annapolis get started on the 30th. We have a wine walk and bar crawl in the afternoon and evening. We also have a VIP dinner at the stadium, the Military Bowl Salute to Heroes dinner, which we've done for the past 2 years, which has been really well received, and it's for different heroes. Medal of Honor recipients who are in town to join us attend that, and it's a nice intimate setting at the stadium. And then day of, you know, we get things started with the parade. Will start at City Dock at 9 a.m. The tailgate will start at the stadium, I believe, at 8:30, which is early, but we know that there's some diehard tailgaters out there. Parking lots will open
you
at 7 a.m. Oh, there are. And people will be excited. I mean, it's essentially a four-day holiday. I mean, you have Saturday, Sunday. Everybody's off Tuesday. You know, I expect a lot of people are going to make a four-day weekend out of it.
Without a doubt. Now, are you one of my favorite things with the Military Bowl is the Medal of Honor recipients. And I get my ass kicked on that all the time. You don't win that. You're awarded it.
We don't have a full lineup yet. I know that two have already confirmed that they'll be with us. I expect we'll have a few more, And, you know, it's neat to have those guys around. I mean, this, their stories are unbelievable. And the thing about it is, to me, they're all really humble. I mean, and we've been joined, last year we had 13 Mail of Honor recipients joining us, from young guys or younger guys like Ed Byers, Flo Groberg, to Woody Williams, who is a legend.
The oldest, right.
Oh, Woody's a legend, and they love him. And
I met him last year. He is fantastic.
Woody is yay tall. I mean, Woody's story is amazing. He tried to enlist, and they wouldn't let him enlist because he was too short. And he kept trying to get in, you know, I mean. And Woody's just amazing, and he's come every year. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to make it this year.
Well, he's 93, I think.
I'm going to take the over on that, actually. I think he's 94 or 95 now.
Okay. Josh pulls out his phone to look
yes,
up here
absolutely.
To find out how old he is. I had the chance to talk with him before the parade, and he served down in the Pacific, not with my father, but in the sort of same division in the Marines. And he just said it was just really, really tough. But these guys that are riding in the parade, that are honored at the game, are absolutely incredible. Where do we get tickets from Military Bowl?
You can visit militarybowl.org. It's probably the best and easiest way to do it. Tickets are on sale now. Things are going to ramp up. The better seats are going to be available now. Once we announce teams, we think we'll get a pretty good run on tickets.
Okay, and then are there, like, suite deals and whatnot that they've got? Are there going to be...
We have different tickets available with some hospitality that we've run every year, and those are available also on the website as well.
Okay. And also, this is at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, and unlike the Navy games, you will be serving, because Budweiser's part of the deal too, alcohol.
There's beer at the game. You know, we want everybody to come, obviously, drink responsibly, but we want people to come, have a great day, you know, come early, come to the parade, make a day of it. We have a pregame show before everything starts with the parachute jump team that's coming every year, and they're always amazing to watch them just kind of fall out of the sky. Like, I'm in the press box before the game, and they just kind of float in, and it's like, holy cow. And sometimes they come in hot. And you're like, oh boy, yeah. Like, and they come in really fast. Like, please don't hurt yourself.
Not here, of all places. Just,
I mean,
not here.
You've got the giant flag. You've got entertainment that's there.
We'll have a special anthem singer this year. We haven't announced yet, but I think it'll be somebody that everybody would want to see. You know, it's just a wonderful day. It all benefits the USO, obviously, of Metropolitan Washington, Baltimore, and Patriot Point, which is the Military Bowl. 2.5 years ago, purchased a 290-acre farm on Maryland's eastern shore to operate as a retreat for injured service members.
Oh, fantastic.
So, you know.
That's fantastic. Now, who can talk about the pregame tailgate? I know Budweiser is one of the sponsors of it. It is official Military Pre-Bowl tailgate, and it is free.
Yes, tailgate is free. You know, we really do encourage everybody to come out and make a day of it. I think that's the best way to pitch this to everyone. It is absolutely worth the time to take the day. Come out, see the parade, make sure that you get to see that. In addition to the Clydesdales, there's just so much that work that goes into that parade, and it's such a great experience. It's really, really like nothing you'll see anywhere else.
I want to interrupt you a little bit, yeah. Lauren, because one of the best things about the parade, I find, is that, as Josh alluded to, the 7 o'clock when the trucks roll in and they unload the Clydesdales. It's pretty special to watch them come off of the trailers, watch them handle them, and the crowds is there. You can get up very close to them. You can get some great pictures where they load up or unload down at City Dock. For the photographers that are listening, the Capitol Dome is right in the background. You've got Ego Alley. It's just a great picturesque time to do it.
It really is, and it's always cold, so bundle up. Yep. It will be cold, even if we ask for 65
Come
and
on,
sunny. It will be cold, but it's absolutely worth it. And, you know, it's great to see the community come out and support the Clydesdales and the parade the way that they do. This whole program is about appreciating the community. It's about appreciating our heroes and the people that are involved. And, you know, we're really grateful that people have embraced the Clydesdales in the same way that, you know, they've embraced the Military Bowl.
It's amazing. You know, the thing to me is I'm down there every year in the morning when they show up, and the sunrise coming up over the water, and, you know, you get, John talked about how the photographers, like, the streaks in the sky are amazing. It's just a neat feeling, like, the anticipation as it builds and people start showing up, and then, you know, all of a sudden you look up and the street's full. I mean, last year it was cold. It was really cold.
Yeah.
I think it was 22 and it felt colder.
It was brutal.
But I'll tell you what, the streets were full of people. I couldn't believe it. You know, I could not believe how many people came out, even in bitter cold weather, and that was as cold as it could be, pretty much. I mean, so I'm sure they'll be crowded again this year, and it'll be a lot of fun.
There's nothing cooler than standing down there in that beautiful moment, like in downtown Annapolis, with the sun coming up and the lighting is just perfect, and these red tractor trailers come rolling with Budweiser Clydesdales
and
on the side.
And they're not dirty trucks either.
These
animals travel in style.
Yeah, they are sparkling clean. They always are. They
given
put
the choice
of
the back of
them.
A Budweiser Clydesdale trailer and a Southwest plane, I think I'm going with the trailer. I think I'm going with the trailer, to be honest.
And then after they unload and the trailers pull off, and everybody starts funneling in and lining up, and the anticipation at the beginning, the Hogs and Heroes and their huge, oversized, loud motorcycles are up front, and they're revving away and trucking for troops and their big pickup trucks, and everybody's just raring to go, and the police are there, and they're like, okay, time to go, and all of a sudden you'll see people take off. I mean, I can remember one year, I want to say it was the Clydesdales, the first year maybe or second year, just took off. They weren't supposed to be first in line, but they just took off.
But it was like,
that's what we're going. Do here. We lead the way.
And they took off and led the way. Okay, let's go.
A shot out of a cannon.
Now, I know you're probably looking for parade participants, or do you have them all set, or do you have anybody that you can tell us that's going to be there that's special?
So we have most of the entries already in. There's still time to register if anybody would like. Just visit militarybowl.org/parade. And you can go on and register. We have different youth groups, community groups. I got a middle school band that reached out to me the other day that says that they are better than any high school band around. So
throwing down some shade.
We have ROTC groups. We'll have, after the AAYFA youth football championships are done, we'll reach out to their championship teams. We invite them to come and be in the parade, and we provide complimentary tickets for the championship teams to come to the game as well. And typically we get anywhere from 8 to 10 of those teams in. The Chesapeake Bayhawks will be represented. I had a phone call this morning with the Washington Nationals. Mike's got a beautiful national shirt on. The Racing Presidents are coming back this year. They will be in the parade. So, it's a total mix of people. It's a lot of fun, though.
And the other thing, do you also, the two teams that will be participating, who'd you say they were again?
Alabama and Clemson.
But
they
do always bring their marching bands, which is something that we don't get to see here in Annapolis with Navy. We don't really have a large marching band. Typically, the teams that are playing here do have a fairly large marching band.
So as the unofficial Military Bowl band liaison, the bands are like their own teams. I mean, they travel. You don't realize it. I mean, so a football team is probably 175 people, including staff.
Right.
The band, a lot of the bands are 250 to 3+, maybe even 350. And they come in, and you have to, plan for the band. There's nothing worse, by the way. One year, we had both bands staying in the same hotel. How do you think it went when the bands had to show up, and we had an early parade that year, and the bands showed up at the same time to try to get everybody down the elevators to the buses? I mean, it seems so silly, but, I'm like, come on, guys, you didn't realize this? we're late for the parade because we couldn't get down. I was like, you're all there. And you have to get 500 kids
from the fifth floor to the
downstairs. But they are their own teams, and they're great to watch perform, and the band cheer, dance, everything.
Right. Yeah, no, that's always a lot of good entertainment. Now, are there going to be chances to win tickets to the Military Bowl throughout the different events leading up into the Mike?
At each one of the Who's Your Hero events, there's going to be chances to win there as well. Doing the same thing, submitting who your hero is, being active in it. Like I said, this program has just grown tremendously. And when we come to accounts and we present it to them, when you try to sell another beer, sometimes you get turned down. When we come down with this program, it's always yes, and which is an awesome feeling. And it just, it pays tribute to how much work, the Military Bowl has put into this, how much work Cassie has done with the Who's Your Hero program. So very much looking forward to it. A lot of fun and exciting events, not only happening in Annapolis, but also around the Annapolis area. I know that there's one going on in Malloy's, Irish Pub, and a couple in Pasadena, and a few events here and there around the areas as well.
Yeah, I haven't seen the full list yet, but I know it's some of the usual suspects. I mean, Langways is a great place.
Yeah.
Down here locally, you've got plenty of different things. Obviously, we're kicking off here at Heroes on Sunday the 11th.
So join us on Sunday for the kickoff, and then please make sure to join us at the tailgate at the Military Bowl to celebrate the conclusion of the program. We'll have plenty of good beer.
And militarybowl.org/parade if you want to get into the parade, or /Bud Heroes, if you want to nominate a hero, you can do that online. But do it in person because that's a lot of fun. You get to taste the Budweiser Copper Lager, new limited edition beer that'll be out. Make sure you get your tickets to the Military Bowl. It's going to be a great time, a great way to ring in 2019 with a bang in the Military Bowl here in Annapolis, Maryland.
I would say it's a great way to showcase your weekend. As Josh alluded earlier, it's pretty much a four-day weekend. Beautiful way just to come down and experience the city if you haven't been there before, or if you are a local, just to come hang out and see what we have going on that weekend.
Well, I'll tell you, that's about it here from Heroes. What we'll do is we'll get some Budweiser Copper Lager. We'll get a burger and call it a day.
This Crab Cake has been brought to you by the Maryland Crabs. Full episodes release every Thursday at noon. Please make sure you subscribe and visit us online at themarylandcrabs.com.